Wrestling USA presents International Championship Wrestling, featuring the top stars of the AWA and the NWA.
This is Jack Reynolds, and I welcome you to Pro Wrestling USA, featuring the greatest superstars in the world of professional wrestling. Coming up, another exciting show today. You'll see the Road Warriors, the World Tag Team Champions, Jimmy Valiant, the Fabulous Ones, Jerry Lawler and Tommy Rich, superstar Billy Graham, Mr. Saito, Harley Race, Dutch Mantell, and a closer look at the boogie-woogie man himself, handsome Jimmy Valiant. With me right now is the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, the one and only Bob Backlund. Bob, welcome once again to Pro Wrestling USA.
Well, it's great to be here, and I want to thank all the people for all their letters. And, you know, I want to explain something to all the people out there, all my friends, because you're all my right behind me, I know it. I'm not here because of them taking the belt away from me. There's another reason. I'm here because they wanted me to lower my standards. I set my standards high so your children can have somebody in sports to look up to. And somebody that you can say to your son, listen to that man. That was one of my goals 3 years ago, to be a perfect example. And nobody's going to tell me to lower my standards or to do something that I can't be proud of, because I've got to live with myself. And all you people know what my motto is, to be a champion within yourself. And I'm not going to be a hypocrite either. I'm not going to go around telling your sons and daughters not to take a pill and sneak around the corner and do it myself. My standards are high, so yours can be a little bit higher. That's the reason I'm here, because my morals were too high and my standards were too high.
The champ, Bob Backlund. Now let's go up to the ring for more exciting action.
The official time, 1 fall, 15 minutes in time, introducing at a total weight of 494 pounds, the Spoiler and Phil Hickerson. And their opponents coming in at a total weight of 456 pounds. Here they are, Stan Lane, Steve Kern, the Fabulous Ones.
What a combination, huh? For those of you that have not seen the Fabulous Ones in action, the combination of Stan Lane and Steve Kern, you are in for a treat tonight. They go up against Phil Hickerson and the Spoiler. 1 fall, 30-minute time limit. There's the bell. And this match officially underway. Right now, the Spoiler and Stan Lane in there. Steve Kern. I'd say these guys, even though they're not twins, but they do resemble each other. They look quite a lot alike, the combination of Stan Lane and Steve Kern. And they are the Fabulous Ones. Spoiler in there right now. Spoiler has been around for a long time. He's a seasoned veteran. Oh! A little Kiss by Grits move in there. Into the turnbuckle. Good move in there right now. Look at that. Steve in there right now. Steve Kern, one half of the Fabulous Ones. All right, there's the tag, and here comes Phil Hickerson. Phil Hickerson, 275 pounds, seasoned veteran. Tag has been made, and Stan Lane in there right now. So we got the new combination of Stan Lane, Phil Hickerson. Look at this. Hickerson can't move him. Look at that. Oh! 265 pounds went crashing against the ring ropes. Headlock in there right now by Hickerson. Coming back with a wrist lock right now. Stan Lane. There's a tag. Here comes Steve Kern. deep in there right now. For those of you that are having maybe some difficulty along with yours truly in trying to identify the combination of the fabulous ones, it is Steve Kern in the ring right now against the Spoiler. Both men bearded, wearing long blonde hair, and they both wear the identical trunks in that ring and boots. Beautiful white boots. Look at this. Spoiler running. Look at that. A tremendous shot in there right now by Steve Kern. Kern right now going to work. Turnbuckle. And here comes his partner, Stan Lane, in there. Lane. Right now, the Spoiler. There's a tag. The Spoiler on the end of some double teaming there by the Fabulous Ones. One. Cross spread in there right now by Stan Lane. There's a tag. There's double teaming going on. Well, these two work well together. And let me say, let me add that the ladies in attendance tonight here on Pro Wrestling USA are enjoying it. They love this combination. Right now, the Spoiler trying to get his partner, Phil Hickerson, to give him a helping hand, and nothing doing. Hickerson can't make a move because they've got the Spoiler tied up. Boots to the head right there. Look at this. Oh, fantastic takedown right there by Steve Kern. Phil Hickerson in there right now. And I'll tell you, I don't think the Spoiler's coming back. Big trip hold. Takedown in there. There's a tag. Steve Kern in there right now. Tag was made by Stan Lane. A Spoiler trying to get in there right now. Stan Lane in there right now. They work well together, the Fabulous Ones. They love it. They do a great job in that ring. And I'll tell you, they use a variety of different holds, ladies and gentlemen. It's just not, you know, let's go at our opponents with all we can give. They use some great professional wrestling holds on their opponents. Make no mistake about it. Hickerson in there right now. Rob loves it. They love it. Spoiler. Paul Morton, referee for this bout, has really, really had his hands full. There's a tag. Steve Kern in there right now. And the Spoiler also getting in there. Look at this. Oh, into the turnbuckle. And they're pounding away right now on Steve Kern. Here comes Stan Lane. Lane coming to the aid of his partner. Lane battling away right now. Into the turnbuckle goes the Spoiler. A whip. Both men feeling the effects of that one. Here we go. Oh, ho, ho. I got to find out what that move was. There's a three count, and it's all over. We'll be back with more Pro Wrestling USA right after this.
My calls are all private. Telco is my phone. It's private calls. The phone on my own. My own photo album. A lock and the key. This phone gets used by no one but me. Buy this for Jenny. Fix this for Glenn. Calls are all private. Telco is your phone. Get private calls. The phone all your own.
tremendous.
It's gigantic.
It's the biggest do-it-yourself warehouse on the East Coast.
It's Mr. Goodbye's on Hudson Street off 22 West in Union.
Featuring over 25,000 Goodbye's, including...
A 36-inch ceiling fan, $23.
You'll never get a better deal.
Marble top vanity, $29.
You'll never get a better deal.
Kitchen cabinets at 50% off.
You'll never get a better deal.
Thousands of rolls of in-stock wallpaper at 40 to 60% off.
You'll never get a better deal.
At these prices, you've got to get to Mr. Goodbye's gigantic Union Warehouse.
You come face to face with our romantic past and eye to eye with our robotic future. You witness the renaissance of an Italian hill town, stroll a booming Texas campus, visit the Queen's Merchants in London, explore the Mexican forest for monarch butterflies winter. You meet a bully president, brave volunteer firefighters, the daring acrobats of old Japan, and the amazing mules of the New South. You discover a whole world in just this one issue of Smithsonian Magazine. And now you can get 12 monthly issues of this remarkable magazine for only $18. Plus, you become an associate member of the Smithsonian Institution, eligible for travel benefits, book, and gift discounts. Nature, art, science, history. Every month, our whole world. There is no other magazine like Smithsonian.
To get the next 12 issues of Smithsonian Magazine for only $18, call toll-free 800-228-3600. That's 800-228-3600. Call now. Whole new worlds are waiting for you.
Ready Cut Carpet's Holiday Sale. All Broadloom, 20% off. All Remnants, 20 to 50% off. Free padding with every carpet. Ready Cut Carpets. It's like having an uncle in the carpet business.
And now, a closer look at the Boogie Woogie Man, Handsome Jimmy Valiant.
Ain't never been there, they tell me it's nice. I live in hotels, tear out the walls. I have accountants pay for it all. They say I'm crazy, but I have a good time. I'm just looking for clues at the scene of the crime. Life's been good. I'm attacked. I'm making records. My fans, they can't wait. They write me letters, tell me I'm great. So I got me an office, throw records on the wall. Just leave a message, maybe I'll call. Lucky I'm sane after all I've been through.
Right now, we have the fabulous Road Warriors going against the combination of Keith Erie and Tracy Smothers. This will be a one fall with a 30-minute time limit. By the way, precious Paul Ellering, their manager, also in attendance. Let's go up to the ring right now with the official announcement.
One fall, 15 minutes in time, this bout. One fall, 15 minutes in time. Introducing first, on my left, a total weight of 449 pounds, introducing the team of Keith, Eric, and Tracy Smothers. Eric and Smothers. Their opponents is 570 pounds. The world tag champion, Animal and Hawk, the Road Warriors. And their manager, Precious Paul Ellery.
You know, Jack, I can't tell them apart. They call them the Road Warriors, and Animal and Hulk. One's got muscles, and one's got more muscles. And they're getting right on top of this, these two other wrestlers. There you see press slams right there. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again joining us here at ringside with a little color commentary on Pro Wrestling USA is the former heavyweight champion, Terry Funk.
I'll tell you what, I'm not envious of either of these fellas wrestling the Road Warriors, because I'll tell you what, I wouldn't want to be in the ring with them. They're tremendously strong. There you see a punch right to the stomach, a forearm to the back, and now he picks him back up again and just throws him across the ring.
Also joining us at ringside right now is the manager of the Road Warriors, Precious Paul Ellering.
Well, it's indeed a treat to be out here with a former world champion, Terry Funk. And I know it gives you just a little shudder of excitement to be here and watch these two men in the ring.
Paul Ellering right now and Mr. Terry Funk.
I'll tell you one thing, Mr. Ellering, that was a fine move right there, that side suplex. Why don't these two fellas wrestle all the time like that? They know wrestling.
Because they're raised in the back alleys. All they know how to do is fight and win and make money at winning, and that's what we do best. We're the kings of pain, and we don't like anybody that don't like to feel pain.
There you see some vicious forearms right there on Tracy Smothers. Throws him in the rope, a double elbow. Down he goes. These fellas like to punish their opponents. They don't like to cover them and try for a pin. They continue on. I've even seen them pick them up off the mat on a two count to keep from getting that pin.
Yes, indeed. When my boys are bad, they're very bad.
Right now, the combination of Keith Eric and Tracy Smothers, just can't get off the ground, literally get off the ground against the Road Warriors.
That's a straight choke. The referee trying to break the man. He's counting every time, trying to get him off that choke, but he breaks before the five count every time.
Hawk in there right now. Hawk, the smaller of the... Well, you can't really know. I guess Hawk is the bigger of the two Road Warriors.
The one with the muscles.
Right, Animal in there right now.
They both got muscles. They got muscles in their teeth.
I like this kid right here. I think he's got some potential. Tracy Smothers in a bear hug right now.
Tremendous bear hug.
Road Warrior on top of him. The other fella can't even take him off of his feet. He's jumping up on his back, trying to get him off of him. Drives him into the turnbuckle. Just pushes Tracy Smothers to the side.
A true smorgasbord of violence. You know, there's a lot of wrestlers that fight great out there, but you're looking at two men that
look
are
at that.
Great fighters.
Boy, you talk about a double combination right there. A little clothesline and a tremendous body slam in there, and it's all over.
I don't blame
Dirty till we beat you again.
Boy, Ellering loves it. He loves it, Terry.
He sure does, and I don't blame Tracy Smothers for staying down for that three count then.
I'll tell you, these Road Warriors are they're like human machines. Let's pick up the action again, Terry Funk.
There you see a bear hug. You see Keith Eric trying to pull him off, but he can't even take him off of his feet. He just drives Keith Eric into the turnbuckle. He's got Tracy Smothers there driving forearms into him. Takes him and whips him into the opposite rope.
There's the clothesline right there. And there's the body slam right behind. Now the press. Animal going for the press. There's the three count, and it's all over. Let's go up to the ring right now and the official decision.
Official time on the win, 3:07. The winners, the World Tag Champion, Road Warriors, the Road Warriors.
This is Jack Reynolds at ringside along with Terry Funk. We'll be back with more right after we take this timeout.
Too bad for you. Your ex has gone to
WPIX 102.
Too bad for you.
Too bad for you.
I found somebody who keeps singing me love songs.
Nothing but love songs.
Hi, I'm Vic Braden, and I'm going to make you a better tennis player. Every month in Tennis Magazine, Tennis, the number one tennis magazine in the world. Number one in keeping you up to date, helping you enjoy and improve your game with sound practical instruction from the world's top teachers like Ash, Hopman, Travert, Vandermeer, even Connors and me.
With news, insights, and updates on all the top players and on the bright new stars. With Tell It Like It Is articles on tennis equipment, apparel, and vacation ideas. Now you can get tennis at a bargain rate. Call 800-255-5000 toll free and get 9 issues of Tennis Magazine for only $6, less than half the newsstand price. Call right now and you'll get free the booklet, Jimmy Connors on Winning Serves and Groundstrokes. That's 9 issues of tennis plus the Jimmy Connors booklet for only $6. But you must call now, 800-255-5000.
Don't forget, we've got a date right here, every month.
One time he almost killed me. He almost put me in the hospital with a chain and board was beaming with it. And me and my mom got away.
You know, those times we had to sleep on top of buildings and, you know, things like that.
They desperately, desperately, desperately want somebody to love.
You can't afford to miss Running Scared, Sunday night at 9 on Channel 11.
Right back with more Pro Wrestling USA. Jack Reynolds at ringside with me right now. A couple of guys that are the fastest rising tag team guys around in professional wrestling. And I'm talking about the one and only Shake, Rattle, and Roll. I'm talking about the Rock and Roll Express.
Hey, kid, the Rock and Roll Express, it's been a long time. We're looking forward to coming down there to the east and do a little rock and rolling down there. You know what I mean?
That's right, Jack. You know, we have a pleasure to be associated with Pro Wrestling USA. And we're looking forward to coming to the east, brother. Because you might have heard about the Rock and Roll Express, but you hadn't seen us yet. And we're going to come rocking. We got a lot of things we can do. We're one of the fastest teams there is around today. And maybe we're one of the quickest. And we could beat you. We could put you down on the mat. We're looking forward to coming to the east. Woo! Huey Lewis, the heart of rock and roll.
I understand that all the young ladies that attend all the professional wrestling bouts, when you guys are in action, are going absolutely wild.
You ain't kidding. They go wild. We come out them doors, boy. The people, you know, it's rock and roll mania. And, I'm proud to hear of you. You know what I'm talking about?
Well, we're glad to have you on Pro Wrestling USA, the Rock and Roll Express. We got Rick Morton and we got and Robert Gibson with us right now, part of the greatest young professional tag team guys that come around in a long, long time. All right, let's go back up to the ring right now for more exciting action. Ah, there he is. Yeah. Superstar. Mr. Billy Graham, ladies and gentlemen. Man who says there is no better than he. As he comes into the ring, there he
is. 1 ball, 15 minutes of time on this bout, introducing at 229 pounds, Ken Raper. Ken Raper. His opponent in this match, with his manager, Jimmy Hart, here he is, Superstar.
Superstar Billy Graham, along with manager Jimmy Hart. I'll tell you, for those of you that have never seen Superstar Billy Graham in action, you are in for something tonight. Am I right, Terry Funk?
You are absolutely right. There is a fella that is known throughout the professional wrestling world who claims to be the best in the world.
Is young Ken Raper in it? 232 pounds, 6 feet, 2.5 inches tall. But I'll tell you, this young man is got to be given a... Uh-oh. Look at this. There he goes. There he goes. Superstar Billy Graham getting into it now with some of the thousands of people in attendance here at ringside. There's the bell. This match is officially underway. And the superstar will be going to work very shortly. He is something to behold in that ring, ladies and gentlemen.
Superstar Grant. Catching Raper with a chop right off the bat. He's letting him know who's the boss. There you have a man of experience against a younger wrestler right there. They tie up in referee's position. Drives the fist right into the forehead of Raper.
I'll tell you, this superstar is a one-man gang. He really gets into it.
He's taking over right now. Taking over. He's not giving anything to Raper. Right there, he takes him down to the mat.
Now, that's illegal.
Whoa, there you see a karate
pose. Yeah, that's illegal.
Right
that's uncalled for, Terry. There's no need for that in the ring.
He doesn't have to beat this young opponent of his with those moves.
Big forearm right to the back. He's undoubtedly one of the strongest men in the world, not just in wrestling, one of the strongest men in the world. Another forearm to the back. Driving Ken Raper right down.
You keep your mouth shut over here, boy.
Oh, he's playing. He is really letting the audience have it with a verbal battle going on. He's got one outside the ring and one inside the ring.
Raper hasn't made one move against Superstar Graham. Hasn't made one successful move.
Manager Jimmy Hart enjoying it all.
There you see a karate blow. That was with the tips of the fingers, and that is an illegal blow in professional wrestling.
Oh, come on now, Superstar.
Now the referee caught it. Now he's on top of him with it, warning him not to use that maneuver again. Driving that foot to the forehead of Ken Raper. Driving it in there again, staying on top of the man, punishing him, kicking him to the back of the neck.
Boy, he really likes to punish his opponents, I'll tell you that.
Picks him up for a slam, drives him down to the mat again. Let's see if he goes for that press yet or not. Nope, brings Ken Raper back up to his feet. Cole Nelson. That's why.
Haven't seen that hold in a long time. But that is his finishing hold, the famous Full Nelson, applied by Superstar Billy Graham.
With arms like that, you can apply that successfully, and he's not turning loose.
Jerry, tell me, when is the last time that you saw a man apply a Full Nelson to his opponent and get a submission hold?
I'll tell you, with arms like that, I can understand it. It's a lot of people can't use it because they don't have the strength to use it.
Tell your wrestling fans, this man is brutal.
Graham not only went ahead and used it successfully, he put Ken Raper out with it.
Here's the official decision.
2 minutes, 22 seconds with a submission hold of Full Nelson, the winner, Superstar Billy Graham.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen. You've seen it all right now. The superstar man, Billy Graham, along with his manager, Jimmy Hart, as they leave the ring. All right, let's pick up the action once again, Terry Funk, as we watch Superstar.
He had him in a position to pin the man, but he picked him up off of his feet. There you see him applying that Full Nelson, locking those hands behind the head of Ken Raper, and he had no choice with the strength that Superstar Billy Graham has other than to go ahead and submit right here. And even after he submitted, Superstar Billy Graham held on for a bit longer. And I'll tell you what, Ken Raper didn't come off that mat for quite a while.
No, he did not. The young man was not only stunned, but he was also a beaten man when he left the ring. All right, we'll be back with more Pro Wrestling USA right after we take this timeout.
Coleco, maker of the Atom Family Computer System, understands that the cost of sending your child to college is growing even faster than your child. Coleco is ready to help. When you buy an Atom Family Computer System between September 1 and December 31, 1984, Coleco will contribute a $500 scholarship toward your child's college education. Now Atom not only helps prepare your child for college, it even helps pay for it.
And I'm the host of Quitting on the Hit. It's a brand new lip sync contest that's packed with the best in pop music, laughs, surprises, and special guest celebrities. Quitting on the Hit is fun for everyone, so join me and a whole bunch of talented people each week as they compete for prize money worth up to $25,000. It's a show that makes you the star you've always wanted to be. That's Quitting on the Hit.
For all the fun, join us tonight at 7, only on Channel 11.
Right back with more at ringside. Jack Reynolds along with the King, Jerry Lawler, and Wildfire Tommy Rich. Jerry, something's got to be done about these Road Warriors.
Well, Jack, I've been watching the monitor in the back, and I've seen these guys on several of these tapes. Without a doubt, they're big, they're impressive, they're tough. But at the same time, you know, they abuse their opponents. They're in there with a lot of these guys that they could, you know, probably beat within a few seconds. But they seem, you know, they seem intent on inflicting a lot of punishment on these guys. I'm just looking forward to seeing them against some a little more worthy opponents, so like possibly Tommy and myself. I think we'd be able to give these guys a little better match. What do you think, Tommy?
Yes, sir. You know, it'd be my pleasure. You know, I'm looking forward to coming to New York and the whole wrestling area up there. Jerry Lawler and myself, we go way back, and I think we'd make a heck of a team to take on the Road Warriors.
All right, that's the combination right there of the King Jerry Lawler along with his partner, Wildfire Tommy Rich. Jerry, congratulations to both of you gentlemen. All right, we're going to go up to the ring right now and the official announcement.
One fall, 15 minutes of time. Introducing first a team coming in at 426 pounds. Introducing the Nightmares, the Nightmares. Their opponent for this bout, introducing at 473 pounds, Tommy Wildfire Rich and Jerry the King Lawler.
We got the Wildfire man in there, Tommy Rich and his partner, the King, Jerry Lawler, against their tag team opponents for this match. Will be the Nightmares.
I wonder if that's midnight.
We're waiting for the bell.
Midnight and any night.
There it is.
Tommy Rich in the ring right now. Both wrestlers facing off each other, coming into a referee's position. There you see an arm bar taken by one of the Nightmares. Rich kicks him off. Comes right back up to his feet.
Once again, joining us at ringside is former heavyweight wrestling champion Terry Funk.
Well, it's a pleasure being here, Jack. Rich shoots him off for a tackle right there. Leapfrogs him, catches him backwards, monkey flip. This Rich has got some great moves on him.
Tommy's been around. I have seen Tommy. I've seen Tommy work in and out of the ring, and I'll tell you, he is a tough customer. He knows how to handle himself.
Well, I'm a little bit, you know, he's an awful good-looking fella. I ain't quite as pretty as Tommy Rich, but he's a great wrestler besides being good-looking. You see Jerry the King facing off against one of the Nightmares. Referee's position, backing into the corner.
Terry, I wanted to ask you, one of the great professional wrestling movies, or a movie that dealt with professional wrestling, was Paradise Alley, in which you co-starred the movie with Sylvester Stallone, Armand Desante, and also Lee Canalito. Whatever happened to Lee Canalito?
Lee went ahead and started to play in that one movie, which I thought was a great movie. It was called Tarzan Movie with Bo Derek. And he got fired before that thing ended, too. So Lee's film career is about like mine.
Well, he had somewhat of a boxing career going, but nothing
yes,
doing.
He had about 15 straight fights, and he won every one of them.
The Nightmares right now taking some punishment from the combination of Jerry Lawler, the King, and Wildfire, Tommy Rich. They work well together, these two.
Yes, they do. They're a great tag team. There you see Lawler blocking him on the outside. Comes into the ring, catches him with a beautiful backdrop right there.
And a nice elbow smash in there by Tommy Rich.
What's he doing in the ring?
Well, you see one of the Nightmares sitting on his laurels, tagging the other one wisely as he comes into the ring. This Lawler, I'll tell you, I've wrestled a lot of professional wrestlers in the world. Lawler can punch as hard as anybody that I've ever faced in a professional wrestling. Beal across the ring on Lawler.
That was a good Beal.
Yes, it was. The Nightmare seems to be very proud of himself right now.
Very colorful outfits that the Nightmares wear.
The other Nightmare wanted in the ring, but the other one said, hold it a minute. He said, I'll try him a little longer.
The referee for this one, by the way, is Paul Morton, veteran ring referee of many professional battles. Look at this.
We see the same thing that they tried on that they used successfully. Whoa! Nice move by Lawler. He outsmarted both of them right there.
Lawler taking on both the Nightmares.
Snap mare by Lawler. That was a legal foot planted into the chest of one of the Nightmares.
A good snap mare.
Throws him into the rope, catches him with an elbow.
Good elbow smash. Tommy likes to use the elbows.
Yes, he does, and he jumped right on top of him. You noticed that whenever that Nightmare had his shoulders that mat, Rich jumped right in there and tried to catch that pin, tried to get in that three count. headlocked by Tommy Rich. Tags Jerry Lawler. Jerry Lawler coming into the ring. Clean break. Now that wasn't too clean. That was a straight fist for one of the matches.
The hard right hand by Tommy Rich. Look at this. Boy, that was a hard
one. Boy, it looked
Lawler
like
felt that one.
Whoa. Threw him into the turnbuckle, comes back again. He's right on top of Lawler. We might have an upset here. We sure might have an upset. Reversal by Lawler. Oh!
Out goes one of the Nightmares. He's hurt. He is hurting. His partner going over to try to give a helping hand, but I don't know whether he's going to be able to get back in here, Terry.
Let's watch them closely here. They look so
back.
Much alike. I
back
thought
they
might have tried to switch for a minute there, Jack, but they didn't.
Trying to tag. There is the tag.
Those fellas are identical in height and size, and you just can't tell them apart. Tag to Tommy Rich. Rich back into the ring. Takes a headlock. Nightmare calling for a knee from his partner. Grabs him, throws Tommy Rich into the ropes. Drops down. And he uses that knee.
Oh, I caught him right in the small of the back with the knee. Tommy in pain right now as the Nightmare's on the way.
Looks like it's all the Nightmares right now. Beautiful move by the Nightmare. That was a bit of a hangman right there, a clothesline. It wasn't quite as successful as what the Road Warriors used, but it took its toll on Tommy Rich.
Double teaming. Look at that.
Oh. They're smart. They'll get on top of him, go for that press. There he goes. One count is all that he got on Tommy Rich.
Lawler trying very desperately right now to tag his tag team partner, Tommy Rich, but nothing more. All right, good move in there by Tommy Rich.
Nice move by Rich. We better try to get to that corner. Lawler's hollering at him, telling him to come on over. Rich coming back up to his feet. Catches him with a big right. Another right. Rich does a forward roll. Tags Jerry Lawler. Whoa. Lawler's mad now. I'm going to tell you, you're going to see some punching here. Both of them are in the ring. We've got all four of them in the ring now. Now you see a pile driver by Jerry Lawler. Right on top of his head.
Martin, referee slow in getting over there. That's it. Oh, the referee was sleeping on that one, Terry.
Well, I'll tell you, he could have probably been 2 minutes later and the fella still wouldn't have got up. That Lawler drove his head right down into that skin.
Let's pick up the action again, Terry Funk.
Yes, sir. There you see that pile driver coming up. Watch his head go into the mat right here. Right down. Right down on that mat.
Now, referee Paul Morton, very slow in getting over there. But as Terry Funk said, 2 minutes later, he could have been over there and it wouldn't have done him any good.
6 minutes, 21 seconds. The winners, Lawler and Rich, 6:21.
The winners of the fall and the match, Tommy Lawler, the King, and Tommy Wildfire Rich. We'll be back with more Pro Wrestling USA right after this.
If you're serious about business, you're already investing a lot of time and money and effort in your career. Now think for a second. Isn't your career, your future, worth 42 cents a day more?
Save $7.50 off the cover price with a subscription to the Wall Street Journal. Order 19 weeks for $39. Phone toll-free 800-453-6600. That's 19 weeks, just $39. And save $7.50. Phone 800-453-6600.
Oh, Sally, what happened?
Oh, strain my back.
I know what'll help. Doane's Pills.
Good advice. Doane's Pills for simple muscular backache pain due to overexertion, stress, or strain. Doane's Pills contain magnesium salicylate, a painkiller found in no other leading analgesic, for relief of minor muscular backache pain for hours.
Just drop by to see how your back feels.
Good enough to fold sheep. Thanks to taking Doane's Pills.
Doane's Pills. Use only as directed.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, joining me at ringside is Mr. Cieto. Mr. Cieto, along with manager Jimmy Hart.
You know, Jack, last week we put up a challenge match to any professional wrestler that would like to crawl in the ring with Mr. Saito. We put up 1 million yen. Well, I tell you what, nobody's called. My phone hadn't been ringing off the wall because everybody evidently is scared of this man. So I'm going to up it. 40 million yen for any professional wrestler or anybody that can crawl in the ring with this man and defeat him. What do you say, Mr. Saito?
Okay, everybody know I'm a strong man. Now, I'm looking for tough competition. I'm looking for strong wrestlers because I'm the best. I'm the best of Japanese. After I find them. I find that American strong wrestler. Maybe Tennessee, maybe New York, who is it? I'm looking for. Because I'm torture. That's my nickname. Hey, somebody told it.
Ichiban, Mr. Saito. Number one, baby, Japan.
Ichiban. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go up to the ring right now for the announcements of our next bout.
One fall, 15 minutes, introducing at 229 pounds, Craig Carson! His opponent at 251 from Tokyo, Mr. Saito. Manager Jimmy Hart, one fall, 15 minutes.
Once again, joining us at ringside, Terry Funk, as Terry looks on with a lot of interest to this exciting match between Mr. Saito and Craig Carson.
Watch this Carson move now. I like the way that this man moves there. Saito's got good balance, so you got to remember he was in the Olympics before. Nice arm drag by Mr. Saito at that time.
I'll tell you, the one thing that impresses me, Terry, so much about Mr. Saito is for a big man, boy, he moves. He's got cat-like moves in that ring.
He sure does. Now he's got the Japanese. He has a form of the Japanese arm bar on Craig right now. And this could very well be a submission. Craig trying to fight out of it, though, the best way that he can. Oh. Trying to keep his shoulders off the mat and trying to come up out of it.
Now, not only does he have the scissors headlock on Carson right now, but he's also working on the left wrist as well.
Yes, he is. That puts tremendous pressure to the elbow joint. Craig came back up, but we saw the hair there. The referee caught it, though.
Oh, look how fast he
referee moves. Right in there. Did you see Carson? This man is doing a good job of refereeing. Carson went ahead, doubled up the fist. Morton said, stop that. Nice reversal. Hammer lock. Leg trip. Back into the riding position.
Oh,
right
it didn't
there.
Have to do that. Didn't have to do that. Had the move. Had the maneuver. Didn't have to do it. He is fast, though, I'll tell you that.
Boy, that's a lot of good wrestling moves. It's a lot of good chops, too. Those are legal chops. Snap mare by Mr. Saito.
Oh, that was the sternum.
That was to the sternum. That was a legal blow at that time.
Boy, and I'll tell you, this Saito is not only quick, but he is powerful in that ring. Look at that.
He seems to have quite a hard head. There was a side kick that just floored Craig right there.
Craig Carson stands 6 feet, 3.5 inches tall, weighs in at 248 pounds. He is a big man, but can't do anything with the legs of Mr. Saito.
Saito's staying right up on top of him right now. Driving that closed fist into the stomach. Takes Carson into the corner right there. It looks like he's going to peel him out of the corner, and he does.
Tremendous peel in there.
Brings him back up to his feet. He's pulling Carson to his feet now. He's got Carson where he wants him.
Good body slam in there by Saito. Call it, Dory. Terry.
There you go, right there. There's a reverse leg hold right there.
Reverse leg hold, and that's it.
That's it for sure right there. There is no escaping that hold.
No,
right there.
I didn't think that young Craig Carson was going to be able to withstand that tremendous pressure and that tremendous finishing hold in there. The reverse leg lock in there by Mr. Saito. Let's pick it up again, Terry Funk.
Right here, you see this reverse leg lock. See, put that leg over the top there. Now
that's
he'll
it.
Turn him totally over.
Wow.
At this time, Craig Carson has got nowhere to go except wiggle his ears or submit. And that's exactly what he chose to do there is submit. That is a great wrestling hold right there that there
All
is
right,
no
we'll
defense
be back.
To.
We'll be back with more. Right after we take this timeout.
Hey, kids, I know a secret magic number. Dial this number, and just like magic, you'll hear adventure stories, scary stories, funny stories, all kinds of stories. Better ask your mom first. But you have to know the secret magic number for Stewie Foam. Write it down. We don't want everyone to have it. How do you get that number?
One day.
Write the number down, kids. 976-3636.
I've tried fad diets, powders, pills. Still, my weight's been up and down like a yo-yo until the AIDS plan taught me how to take off weight and help keep it off.
AIDS may taste like a candy, but AIDS contains one of the most effective appetite suppressants you can buy, and there's no stimulant in AIDS that could make you nervous.
With AIDS, I ate less, so the weight came off. To help keep it off when I sometimes want things loaded with calories, AIDS helps put me in control.
The AIDS plan can teach you how to take off weight and help keep it off. Try new peanut butter AIDS.
You'll have a great time in New York City, east side of town, at the Hotel Seville. We do great cooking, honey. We'll treat you right.
We know you'll love your bill.
Remember, in New York City, Hotel Seville.
Your friendly home away from home.
Our friendly home away from home.
Madison Avenue and 29th Street.
With me right now, a lot of people refer to him as the body beautiful, the one and only Tony Atlas. Tony, welcome to Pro Wrestling USA.
Well, you know, that Pro Wrestling USA sure do make me feel good for somebody to say USA. You know, a couple of while back, I won an old title. And that title was a Mr. USA title. It was a bodybuilding championship. And back in my past, I won a whole lot of weightlifting competition. And I did a whole lot of stuff for my family, made my family kind of proud of me. You know, when I was a little kid, I used to get up and sweep the floor. And the floor I used to sweep was dirt. I used to get up early in the morning, I used to break ice in order to wash my face. Shake a little snow off my blanket because the roof had a lot of holes in it. And then all of a sudden, I became one of the best things that ever happened today in my life. I became a professional wrestler. And becoming a professional wrestler was better than me. Becoming a bodybuilder and winning the USA title was better than winning all them weightlifting contests. And it was better than anything that ever happened for me. And now I'm in the AWA, one of the finest organizations of professional wrestling in the world today. And I like competition. Every day I go in the gym, I might lift 500 pounds. Then all of a sudden, 500 pounds ain't good enough. I had to put 10 more pounds on there because I like to keep challenging myself. I like to do the best that I could do because it's very certain that old poor country boy like myself get a chance of being somebody. Everybody that I go back to my hometown, they come up and they shake my hand, pat me on the back, say, Tony, you went out, you made something out of yourself. We proud of you. Well, I want them people to keep on being proud of me. I don't never want to let the fans down because if it wasn't for the fans getting out there saying, go, Tony, USA, 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 I wouldn't be the man that I am today. I don't take credit for nothing I do. I give all the credit to people like Vern Gagne and all the fans that pushed me all through the years. And people, when I come, I don't care who they put in there. They can go to the zoo and get Willie B, that great big old gorilla. I slap him and take his television. I don't care, because nothing's going to stop
me. Tony Atlas, Mr. USA. All right, let's go back up to the ring right now for more exciting action. Right now is the former AWA wrestling champion, the one and only Harley Race.
He was a 7 times NWA World's Heavyweight Champion.
I beg your pardon, NWA Champion.
Time limit bout, weighing in at 224 pounds, Dutch Mantell. Mantell. His opponent in this match. For this one fall, 15-minute time limit bout, 224, introducing Dutch Mantell. Mantell. His opponent, former world champion, Harley Race. Harley Race. One fall, 15 minutes.
You know, they call him Handsome Harley Race, and I'll be darned if I can figure out why.
That's the voice of Terry Funk. Jack Reynolds at ringside, Pro Wrestling USA. Referee has called for the bell, and the match officially underway.
Dutch Mantell is a great wrestler. He's internationally known. It should be a great wrestling match.
As you mentioned, Harley Race,
seven times NWA World's Champion.
Wow.
And he wants it an eighth time, too, and he sure enough might get it. There you see a knee into the gut of Dutch Mantell. Picks him back up.
Now, what is the Sheik doing here again? What's the Sheik doing here again?
I have no idea what he's doing, Mark.
Look at him walking around. He's walking around. There he is. What's he doing here again? Oh, that's right. He's looking for talent. I guess he is, of course, he has seen Harley Race in action before.
Oh, did you see the knee to Dutch Mantell's forehead? Harley Race picking him back up, driving him into the turnbuckle. Dutch Mantell hurt him. Taking him out of the turnbuckle, another knee to the midsection of Dutch Mantell, driving him back into that turnbuckle again. It's been all Harley Race so far.
I might add, wrestling fans, for those of you that may be familiar, and maybe some of you are not, there is no love between the likes of Terry Funk and Harley Race.
There's no love, but there's respect for the man.
That's
any true. Time that the man has been that successful in his profession, you have to respect him. Pile driver by Harley Race. One, two, that's... I thought that was it for sure, Jack.
Looked like he had him.
Well,
looked
I'll
like it
what,
was all over.
I know, Mantell came out of it. I'll bet that surprised Race.
Headbutt. Look at that. Little headbutting going on. Look at that.
Oh, a second one right there. Mantell almost out on his feet. Short left. The face of Mantell. Another short left.
Seven-time world champion.
Here comes the vertical suplex right there. Race holding
Look at
him up
that.
Straight
Tremendous
up in the air.
Move in there. Bring suplex.
This has got to be it, Jack. This has got to be it. One, two, three.
That's it.
That was it right then. That was it. Race went ahead and
caught
with a
freak out
there.
Tremendous victory, Harley Race.
It was close. It was close.
What? I'll tell you, I haven't seen. Let's pick up the action once again, Terry Funk. Call it.
Let's see if we get that. There's that vertical suplex. Let's see if Mantell's shoulders were off that mat at the three count or not. There you see Race having him, holding him in a vertical suplex. Drops him back. Coming in for the pinning position. Referee comes in there. One, two, three. He was down for the three count, Jack.
It was a three count. All right, let's go up to the ring announcer right now and get our official decision.
2 minutes, 2 seconds, the official winner, Harley Race. Harley Race in 202.
We'll be back with more following this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the commercial you're about to see has been reduced to $19.95 in your market for a limited time. Plus, two additional items have been added. If purchased separately, the men's bracelet alone sells for $149.
This elegant masterpiece in 14-karat gold in today's gold market would cost you $2,200 or more. Do you know someone who wears a bracelet this handsome? It's a full-bodied, 126-facet, 2-ounce heavyweight. You'd only expect to see something this beautiful on someone very successful. Like a perpetual diamond, it's blazingly on fire. Thanks to Santo Gold, a new process created this year, it's yours for only $29.90. A national mail-order magazine advertises a 1.5-ounce version costing $149, but ours is a full 2 ounces. Picture it on someone you love. And men, picture this on someone you love. It's free when you purchase the man's. Look at how our planned multi-million-dollar test allows this 5-year warranty. If at any time within 5 years there is a problem with your bracelets, even if lost or stolen, we'll replace them free. Simply return the enclosed 5-year policy with a brief explanation. All you pay is $2 to help cover handling. Within 48 hours, we'll rush your replacement by air free.
Ladies and gentlemen, keep watching this commercial for a special test price in your area of only $19.95, plus two added bonuses at no additional charge.
Don't worry, just like an insurance company, we also calculate our percentages. This is our direct wholesale cost to you with no middleman. Listen to this. Wear them for 30 days, and if for any reason you're not completely satisfied, receive all your money back and keep the beautiful Santo Gold Ladies Bracelet free. Santo Gold, the gift that lasts.
Order now and you'll receive this beautiful quartz watch plus this supernatural diamond ring, both free. Hold everything. For a limited test time in your market, we're now letting all four items go for the incredible low, low price of only $19.95. Call now, toll free, 1-800-453-1234 for the Santo Gold bracelets, the elegant quartz watch, and this 0.25 carat supernatural diamond ring. Save the COD charges and send only $19.95 and $3 shipping to Santo Gold, Box 1000, Oldenton, Maryland. You must be 100% satisfied to return everything for a full refund, and you keep this beautiful ring free.
Another exciting hour of Pro Wrestling USA. Bob, where does the time go?
Boy, oh boy, it was an enjoyable hour. It was a lot of fun. I don't know if those people out there are as excited as I am, but I've really enjoyed this hour, and I can't wait to get to come back and be with Pro Wrestling USA next week.
And coming up next week, you're going to see the great superstars of professional wrestling, the Fabulous Ones. Superstar Billy Graham will be joining us. The AWA champion Rick Martel. Dory Funk Jr., a legend in his own time. Also, Precious Paul Ellering, Mr. Saito, and the combination of Tony Atlas and Butch Reed. How about that for excitement, Bob?
Oh, that sounds good to me. I'm going to look forward to all those matches.
All right, this is Jack Reynolds along with Bob Backlund. Thank you for joining us, and we'll be back with more Pro Wrestling USA.
Tonight at 8, James Garner's a sore loser when he wins $100,000 in a poker game and somebody goes and steals it. The West was never won.